Hi friends, good morning, good afternoon and good evening. Let's summarize what is that we have learned so far as journal entries are concerned. Because we will move into the next chapter lectures, but before that we should be clear on the basics of journal entries. Journal entries forms the basis of any business transactions. And journal entries are processed basis the time the entry is the transaction has occurred, like it is processed basis the chronological order. Third is the correctness of the journal entries can be obtained through the narrations what we enter, like purchase of furniture, sold goods to XYZ on credit, sold goods at a profit of 10%. All this type of journal narrations what we enter plays a major role in finalizing the transaction and understanding the transactions journal entries. And journals forms the basis of posting into ledgers. The next important points what we have to remember while processing a journal entry is transactions has to be entered, has to be entered only basis the source document. We discussed about the source documents like pay in slip or the salary vouchers or the invoices, purchase entries, purchase invoice received from the suppliers and goods receipt note. There should be some source document basis which alone a journal entry has to be processed. Without any source document, a journal entry should not be processed. And there are two aspects involved into the journal entry, naming debit and credit. See, we are working in a dual aspect concept. For every debits, there should be an equal and corresponding credit entry that should be there. Without which, the journal entries will not match and journal entries should not be processed without a corresponding credit entry for a debit entry. And similarly for every credit entries that we process, there should be an equal and corresponding debit entry that should be available. And accounts are classified, the next important point, accounts are classified into personal, real and nominal. Personal accounts deals with person, artificial person and representative persons, like any name like Babu, Hari, Shilpa, etc., etc., any name that's coming in as a personal. Artificial persons can be any companies like XYZ company, ABC company, Babu Muralidharan company, etc. Artificial persons. And representative persons, namely prepaid rent, outstanding salary, etc. These are all representative persons. Then comes the real account, which deals with assets. Basically, anything that helps in increasing the revenue or income are called as assets. And all those real accounts are categorized into this category. Third category of accounts are nominal accounts. Nominal accounts deals with expenses, losses, revenue and liabilities. So accounting equation is assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. This accounting equation should not forget the accounting equation. Assets is equal to capital plus liabilities. Then comes the golden rules of accounting. Because the transactions are first entered in the journal entries, golden rules has to be by hearted. Let's repeat that one more time. Personal account is equal to debit the receiver and credit the giver. Real account rule is debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Nominal account rule is debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gains. So these are all the basic concepts in journal entries. I hope you have understood this and please come back to me if you have any doubts or clarifications. While we move into the next chapter, journal ledgers, we will also try to answer some of the questions that is coming into your mind, and please comment on this so that we can probably see that any clarifications that you require, I can try to address it. Thank you friends and have a great day.